Hi, nice to see you again. Today we're doing this. We are going to create a transition between shots using the track mat key effect. The track mat key effect is actually pretty simple to apply, and the effect is downright straightforward. But make no mistake about it, this is a very powerful and useful effect. With the track mat key, we can reveal and hide specific parts of a video layer using shapes or text, for example. By doing so, we can create transitions. Let's start off by creating a transition using a shape. On video track 1, we'll put the footage we want to start with. On video track 2, we'll put the footage we want to go to. Now, make the two pieces of footage overlap at the point where you want the transition to take place. Next, let's add a shape, a rectangle for example. Select the rectangle from the tools panel and draw it over the video. If you want it to be a perfect square, make sure to hold down shift while drawing. The rectangle will now be on video track 3. In the effect controls panel, under shape, we're going to fill and make sure it's set to completely white. Why? I'll show you in a second. With skill and position, we're going to make sure that the shape takes up the entire screen. Add keyframes at where we want the transition to end. Next, we're going to where we want the transition to start. With scale and position, we'll make sure that the rectangle is completely outside of the frame. Perhaps a little easing to our movement, and this is what we've got so far. Now, we're going to the effects panel and look for the track mat key effect. Apply it to the video footage on track 2, and in the effect controls panel, we will set the mat to video 3. Pretty nice, right? By default, the composite using is set to matte alpha. With this setting, the second video layer will be visible at the place of the shape, no matter what color it actually was. You can change the color of the shape to say gray, and it doesn't make a difference. However, if we go back to the effect controls of video track 2 and change the composite using to matte luma, you can see what that does to the transparency. The darker the color of the original shape on the layer the track mat key is linked to, the more transparent it will be. So this gives us a great way to play with the transparency. Let's go back to the shape layer and set the fill back to completely white. Now add a stroke, which will make gray, increase the width. With the composite using set to matte luma on the track mat key effect on the second video track, we now have a semi-transparent border. And the great thing is, we can do this with just about everything. Try replacing the shape with a circle, or with a text, or even better yet, draw your own shape, or import a PNG file. You can also add more layers. Like I said, it's actually pretty simple and straightforward, but you can do so incredibly much with this effect. So let's get creative and show me what you've got.